When you leave Oxford and take a job as assistant English master at Allien School, Dulwich, London, not even you realize the National Youth Theatre was about to take root. For it's at Allien's you're put in charge of school play productions. And if you look at that screen, Michael, we're going to go back to that school where two of your former pupils, who've since gone on to stage and television fame, recall your production of Julius Caesar. John Stride and Julian Glover.
Hello, Mike. See where we are? In front of the old school pavilion, where you did your very first production here of Julius Caesar in modern dress, in which I played the part of Mark Antony.
In which I should have played the part of Mark Antony.
But you didn't. You played Artemidorus.
Who nobody's ever heard of.
Who was, in fact, a school teacher. And because we did it in modern dress, because we didn't have any tradition of theatre here, no costumes or anything, we all had to wear modern clothes, obviously, and you were dressed as a schoolmaster.
Artemidorus, dressed as a schoolmaster, presenting his petition to Julius Caesar. Which, when he failed to get accepted, the mob set upon Artemidorus, and the mob was a load of schoolboys. And passing along Townley Road was one of the peaceful Dulwich ladies, many of whom live around here, who suddenly thought the revolution had broken out in Allien School, so she rang the police, who came screaming around here and caused a great furore, or furore, is it? I don't know. And we got in the national press. Which
one?
Well, brought Shakespeare to life.
Oh, so it did. It made us feel that Shakespeare really was to do with us. And in fact, you had certain tricks up your sleeve which made the audience feel it was to do with them too, like...
Well, I think Mike had the common touch. He's probably still got a common touch, because one of the lighting effects, if you remember, at the Battle of...
Philippi
was to set the school lavatory alight. No, he did. He set the school lavatory alight. This building here. And that's how you started the National Youth Theatre, Michael, with a bang. And I think both of us, joking apart, would like to say thank you very much for the encouragement and the sort of start you gave our lives.
Thank you, Michael. The man without whom.
Thank you, John Stride and Julian Glover. Well, it's while you're at Allien School, Michael, you wrote the best-selling novel of school life, later made into a film, Spare the Rod, and you decide to quit teaching to become a writer. But you'd so inspire those boys at school, they didn't want their involvement in drama to end with your departure.
So a few of us got together to persuade Mike to keep it going during the school holidays.
Former Coronation Street star Kenneth Farrington. And two more actor old boys from Allien School, Richard Hampton and David Weston. Well, now, Kenneth, you must have been very keen.
Not to start off with, I was by then, but Mike had a genius, actually, for motivating and inspiring the deadbeats, the dropouts, and all the rebels of the school. There's a lot of people, actually, who are a hell of a lot to Mike. They completely changed their lives. I was in the under-16 football team, which Mike used to run, and he came to the team and said, would we all be in the crowd for Julius Caesar, which was his first production? And we said, no way did we want to be puffy actors. And then he dropped the hint that after the last night, there were going to be the odd beer floating around, and so we were all behind him to a man. And that's how we all got interested in acting and beer.
So, Richard Hampton, Michael did get a production going.
Yes, he did. After leaving Allien's, the idea was taking root, I guess, and he spent the time trying to raise money to support the scheme. Nobody was interested, and so finally, 7 months later, he called for all of us and got us together and said, we've got to do it now or we'll never do it at all, and we'll revive a production of Henry V, and he backed it with his own money, and September 1956 at the Toynbee Hall, Henry V, Michael's first production of the Youth Theatre, and that was it. We were on our way.
So, David Weston, what happened next?
Well, then the boys at Allien's thought other boys should have the benefit of Michael, and so we had the idea of the National Youth Theatre, and he started having auditions around the country, and from that grew this national institution, which he's the head of now.
Thank you, David Weston, Richard Hampton, and Kenneth Farrington.
Nice poet.
Following summer, you managed to get your company of youngsters into a West End theatre, and one schoolboy at Bromley, Kent, looks at a school notice board and sees you're inviting auditions. That's how he comes to make his West End debut at the Queen's Theatre in Shaftesbury Avenue, where he's made a return appearance to greet you now. International film star Michael York.
Hello, Michael, and hello, Eamon. It was with Shakespeare and in London, and indeed here in the Queen's Theatre, that it all began. All those years ago with your now famous production of Hamlet, in which I, for my sins, had one line. I have a lot to thank you for, not least for that initial encouragement. I want to thank you, too, for, in fact, the education that you provided us in so many ways. I'm thinking about those marvelous tours that we had, those jaunts into the unknown, bringing Shakespeare to the Dutch, and to Paris, representing our country. Paris really was an extraordinary trip. It was an education in more senses than one, because I remember, well, do you remember that hotel that you booked, that in fact turned out to be a house of, well, ill repute. And I only wish I was with you to be able to toast the next 21 years. But God bless you and all the best. And oh, by the way, that one line was, in that and all things will I show my duty. And I just hope that all of us tonight have managed in some way to show our duty to you. Thank you.
Thank you, Michael York. Well, Michael, we've heard how the National Youth Theatre had its beginnings at the Allianz School in Dulwich, but boys have to be 14 to be in the plays. And when you leave, one boy, not quite 14, thinks his chance to act has gone.
But, Mike, you gave me my big chance because another lad's voice broke.
Today he's a star of stage and films after a 7 years apprenticeship with you, Simon Ward. So what happened, Simon?
Well, Mike had already left school, but he was just starting up the first production of Henry V at Toynbee Hall. And as it was entirely cast with boys from Allianz, there was obviously no one to play the female part, so we had to cast it inside the school. And there was a bit of a problem because the lad who was going to play Catherine, his voice suddenly broke. And Mike remembered me from school and gave me my chance, and I stayed with him until I was 21. And it was an extraordinary experience because, you see, Mike has got this ability to enthuse people, but in a very down-to-earth way, and to I think, open windows in kids' imaginations and minds. And that's why we all still feel this tremendous sense of loyalty towards him and gratitude.
Thank you. Thank you, Simon Ward.
Thanks, Simon.
Well, Michael, you invited someone very special to see that first production of the Youth Theatre, someone who was so impressed that though he cannot be here tonight, he's still very much a part of your National Youth Theatre. And if you look at that screen, he's broken off rehearsals at the National Theatre to greet you now, one of Britain's most distinguished actors, Sir Ralph Richardson.
Well, Michael, this comes to you by the courtesy of Albert Finney, because this is Albert's dressing room. He's lent it to me. My dressing room isn't ready yet. Maybe they're doing it up for me. Or maybe they're doing me down for it. Well, Michael, you're a genius, aren't you? Genius, well, that's a word, you know, that's sometimes rather carelessly used. So I looked up in the dictionary to see what the definition is. Genius is a noun, tutelary, spirit or person for good or evil. Tutelary, well, that suits you, Michael, doesn't it? Because you teach young people acting. Now, whether for good or evil is the question. Well, I suggest that in your case, it's for good. It's been said that Britain's victories were won on the playing fields of Eton. That's where they played cricket. Now, cricket is an athletic exercise practiced in a team. And acting is an imaginative and poetic exercise also practiced in a team. Now, if you could teach your young people to use poetry and imagination in any walk of life, I don't mean just in acting, you would be doing good.
Have you finished with my room, Sir Ralph?
We've absolutely finished, Albert. Every drop, we found it in the cupboard.
We finished the finest finish work.
Indeed, yes, but there's just that wee drop left.
Well, thank you.
Here we are, and with that, let's drink a health to Michael Croft.
To Michael Croft.
Michael.
Thank you, Sir Ralph Richardson, Albert Finney. Well, there we come to a close. But of course, the theatre you created 21 years ago goes from strength to strength. And I know your evening would not be complete without the new hopefuls of your company. And they're here. From London's East End, from Buckinghamshire, from Fulham, schoolboys, college students, still working, there's a wages clerk, a potter, all of them the newest members of a 21-year tradition. And finally, Michael, the very first girl you cast in a production when she was a teenager went on to Hollywood stardom in films such as the award-winning A Lion in Winter, and it's from Hollywood we've flown her tonight, Jane Merrow.
Hi, Jane. Hello, darling. Hello.
Jane, living and working in Hollywood now, I know you still think back on those days working with Michael with great affection.
Yes, I certainly do. I think it was one of the happiest and most fulfilling times of my life. And I think I can honestly say that in the 2 weeks that we rehearsed Julius Caesar, I learned more about acting and communicating a play to an audience than I did in 2 years at drama school.
Wow.
Thank you, Mike, for doing so much for me. And I know that you're going to do the same for many, many more young people who are lucky enough to come in contact with you.
Thanks, Jenna.
Michael Croft, director of the National Youth Theatre, this is your life.